Recently, I uploaded this video about squatting with osteoarthritis. The video covers exercise progressions and supportive exercises to help those with osteoarthritis squat. One of the viewers asked a great question in the comments regarding noise coming from her knees when she squats. She asked, "When I do the squats, I notice that there is a click sound from my lower limb when I bend, but I'm unsure if it's from the ankle or the knee as there's no pain. The click sound is not just once or twice, but if I say do 3 sets of 10 reps, it's 30 times the clicking sound. The problem of noise is coming from the knee, whether it be clicking, grating, crunching, popping, creaking, or grinding, is not uncommon with those with osteoarthritis. And it is not just common during squats, but also other activities like walking up and down the stairs, sitting up and down from a chair, or getting in and out of bed. And really, any movement that involves bending or straightening the knee. Welcome or welcome back to Age Fit with Tess. My name is Tess Haubauer, physiotherapist. By the end of this video, you are going to know some of the likely causes of noise in knees with osteoarthritis, different types of noises that may occur, and what this means for pain and function. Join the Age Fit with Tess Facebook group to get further support managing pain, building strength, and gaining fitness. To book a consultation or apply for the Fit with Arthritis program, head to www.agefitwithtess.com. While there may be more than one reason for this clicking in the knees for this viewer, for those with osteoarthritis, the most common is classified as crepitus. And a definition of crepitus from arthritishealth.com is any grinding, creaking, grating, cracking, crunching, or popping that occurs when moving a joint. These noises can be quite concerning when experiencing them, especially because it can be difficult to know where the noise is coming from or to know the cause of the noise. One differentiation and explanation that I have seen is from physiotherapist Claire Robertson. Claire described the following noises that may come from the knee that could be classified as crepitus. The first is isolated pops or cracks. For instance, the noise of knuckles cracking. These pops or cracks are generally attributed to the physiological process called cavitation, where small air bubbles that develop within the synovial or joint fluid collapse again. These pops or cracks are usually not associated with pain, and there is no evidence that these pops or cracks cause osteoarthritis. The second is a clunking noise, and this is often described as the patella or kneecap moving into the trochlear groove or the kneecap groove of the femur. And this may be a result of incorrect patella tracking, where the patella does not stay in the trochlear groove completely during movement. And this noise is generally associated with a feeling of a relief rather than pain, as the patella realigns with the trochlear groove. It is also important to note that this noise is not coming from the tibiofemoral joint or the weight-bearing joint, but rather the patellofemoral joint between the patella and femur, which is not weight-bearing. And this is important because it's usually that weight-bearing joint, the tibiofemoral joint, that causes pain for people with osteoarthritis. And the third is a fine grating sound. And this can be attributed to synovial fluid moving behind the cartilage on the back of the patella during movement. And this can be heard as that fine grating sound that occurs multiple times during movement. And this noise is often misinterpreted as bone rubbing on bone or a harmful noise. Again, this noise is generally coming from the patellofemoral joint, which is non-weight bearing. When understanding what these noises mean, some key points have been found in research. Noise should be disassociated from pain, i.e. noise does not equal pain. Noise should be disassociated with knee function, i.e. noise does not equal harm to the knee joint. Noise should not be the limiting factor for activities. For example, squats, walking up the stairs, and doing exercises. Noise is not associated with the occurrence of knee joint replacement. For instance, noise does not mean a knee joint replacement is needed. And noise is associated with lower self-reported function, but not objective measures of strength and function. So, i.e. those with noise perceived lower function. It is important to note that these points are regarding more chronic knee noises in osteoarthritis. Less frequently, noises from the knee may be attributed to acute injury, like an ACL tear, meniscus injury, or post-surgery crepitus. The main differentiating factor here is that these noises are attributed to a single event or trauma to the knee, which a person is likely to remember. These noises we are talking about in this video cannot be attributed to a single event or trauma, and are typically ongoing over a prolonged period of time with some of these movements. So for our viewer, the noise experience could be attributed to one of these types of crepitus. While these noises likely won't go away, they should not be the limiting factor to function and participating in activities like squats, walking up and down the stairs, and doing exercises. For further information on knee crepitus, there are links in the description to websites and research articles. And if you have a question that you would like answered on this channel, make sure to leave a comment below. Remember to join that Age Fit with Tess Facebook group to get further support managing pain, building strength, and gaining fitness. If you have osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, or chronic joint pain and are unsure if you have the right exercise program put together, make sure to get the complimentary Fit with Arthritis self-assessment to identify if you are meeting 10 key components of a successful exercise program. Head to www.agefitwithtess.com to get your copy. To continue to manage pain, build strength, and gain fitness in the meantime, watch these videos right here. See you next time.